online. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Oh, sorry. Hold on 1 second. I'm texting with a friend about something that happened at school today. In fact, it was the worst thing that's ever happened to me. What if we just don't talk to him anymore? That'll drive him crazy. Anyway, we're talking about forgiveness all month long, which can come in handy when dealing with problems, especially problems at school that were totally not my fault. Get comfortable and I'll tell you all about it in 1 second. Oh, he is so the worst. I can't think of anyone I dislike more. Anyone out there have to sit in pods at school? It's like four desks pushed together and you're just with these people all day long, every subject, every project, every day. So the first half of my year, my pod was great. I had one of my best friends with me. We all got along. It just worked. Well, after the holiday break, my teacher was like, "Oh, you know what would be so fun? If I ruin the rest of Lex's school year." Obviously, I don't know if she said that, but it's definitely what it feels like. I'm now in a pod with Jeremiah, who is always getting in trouble. And now he's making me get in trouble. He was talking so loud today, so I asked him to be quiet. Well, then we both got in trouble for talking and had to pull a yellow card. And then later in the day, he thought it'd be so funny to take my water bottle. So I grabbed it back and gave him a little shove. The teacher saw me, and then I had to pull a red card. A red card! I've never pulled a red card in my life. My good girl streak is over and it's all downhill from here. I'll probably get sent to the principal's office tomorrow. I'll never forgive that kid. He's ruined me.
Hey everyone, my name is Jean, and I want to ask you a question, but I don't want you to answer out loud, because your answer may be someone in the room with you. I want you to think about a person who was really mean to you. Maybe they lied to you about something or said something hurtful to you. Maybe they took something of yours or left you out of something fun on purpose. Whatever it is, I want you to think about that person. I'll give you a couple seconds. Now that everyone has someone in mind, I think we're ready. Today we're gonna talk about someone who was mean to people. A lot of people. Basically, a whole town of people. Believe it or not, pretty much his entire town was mad at him. There was a man named Zacchaeus who lived in the city of Jericho. Zacchaeus was the local tax collector. He collected money from the people of Jericho and gave it to the Roman government. But Zacchaeus, like a lot of tax collectors of his time, took a lot more money from the people than he was supposed to. And he kept it for himself. That's called stealing, right? So yeah, you could say that people were mad at him.
It's $10, right?
No, it's 20 now.
But I can't.
Too bad, pay up or you go to jail. Oh. Come on. Next.
I have what you want, but I'll need some change back.
I don't give change. Next.
Look, sir, it's been a terrible year for us. I don't have the extra you're asking for.
Oh, well, that's too bad. You know what? You don't have to pay this year.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Just kidding. Pay up or jail. Next.
Zacchaeus felt pretty important and pretty powerful. After all, everyone, and I mean everyone, had to pay Zacchaeus taxes or they got into trouble. It didn't make Zacchaeus a very popular person, but it sure made everyone afraid of him. Zacchaeus was all right with that, at least until one day. One day Jesus stepped into Zacchaeus' story and here's what happened. Everyone had heard about Jesus and all the amazing things he had done. He was healing people and being a friend to everyone. And on this one day, Jesus came to Zacchaeus' town. So, of course, everyone wanted to see him. Even Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus. There was just one problem. There was a huge crowd, and Zacchaeus couldn't see over them because he wasn't very tall. I'm not sure if Zacchaeus even bothered asking anyone to let him through, but since nobody liked Zacchaeus, he probably thought no one was gonna let him through anyways. So he did what no grown-up really does. He climbed a tree. Hold on. Are you just on a ladder behind a houseplant?
What, you thought we were gonna get a real tree up in this studio?
Okay, great point. As Jesus walked by the tree he was in, he saw Zacchaeus and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." As quickly as he scrambled up the tree, Zacchaeus came back down and took Jesus to his house. Now, the people in Zacchaeus' town were not happy about this. They couldn't imagine why Jesus would want to hang out with a thief. He stole people's money, and now Jesus is like, "Hey, take me to your house, let's talk." But they were missing the point. Jesus believed that everyone was important and valuable, even the people who stole money. And he knew that everyone should be forgiven, even a thief like Zacchaeus. You know what? Jesus was right, because when Zacchaeus experienced Jesus' forgiveness, it changed him.
Oh, you know what? Don't give me a dime. I owe you a refund from last year.
Really?
Yeah, how about?
Twice as much as what you paid last year.
Wow, thank you so much.
It's my pleasure. Who's next? Oh, you. I remember you.
You do?
Yeah, and if I remember correctly, I cheated you. Take back 4 times as much as what I took.
Wow, that's amazing.
No, I wronged you, and you don't deserve that. Who's next?
Zacchaeus experienced Jesus' forgiveness, and he changed. He became a new person. The people that Zacchaeus cheated and hurt were right to be upset with him. He cheated, he lied, and he was mean to everyone. I bet they were wondering how Jesus could forgive a man like Zacchaeus. We probably would have wondered the same thing. What Jesus did for Zacchaeus is what he wants us to do for people. Jesus wants us to forgive others no matter what. And being forgiven helped Zacchaeus to change the way that he treated others. He was changed by the way Jesus loved him. If Jesus forgives others no matter what does that mean for us? Does Jesus really want us to forgive others no matter what? Think back to that person in your head who hurt you or was mean to you. It's okay that you felt hurt by what they did. It does make us angry or upset when someone is mean to us. But Jesus doesn't want us to carry that hurt or anger around. He wants us to forgive. Now, some things are easy to forgive. Maybe you've already forgiven that person in your head. That's great. But some things, some hurts, are bigger and they're harder to forgive. Maybe you haven't forgiven that person yet, and that's okay. If you haven't, you should pray and ask God to help you forgive. And you can always talk to an adult you trust and ask them to help you understand more about forgiveness too. Jesus can help us forgive others even when we don't feel they deserve it. So the next time you look at someone in school, in your own house, or out in the world and think, "I could never forgive him," or "She's so mean," remember what Jesus did for Zacchaeus. Jesus forgave, and he wants us to forgive too. Let's live and love like Jesus and choose to forgive others no matter what, even if they hurt you, even if you think they don't deserve it. Forgive others no matter what, because that's what Jesus does, and he will help us do the same. Let's pray. God, thank you for the story of Zacchaeus and for showing us that we should forgive everyone even when we don't think they deserve it. Help us choose to forgive others no matter what. Amen.
Truth from God, because he loves us.
Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. Colossians 3:13.
Learn it, lock it, live it.
I don't want to do it. I don't want to forgive Jeremiah. The whole class is annoyed by him. If I forgive him, what does that show him? What will people think of me? If I forgive him, what does that show him? Well, I guess it shows him that I'm different from everyone else, that I'm trying to live like Jesus asked me to live. Forgive others, no matter if they said they're sorry, no matter if they don't ask for forgiveness, no matter if they ruin your spotless reputation. And what will people think of me? Well, everybody can hold a grudge and ignore someone or talk about them behind their back. But showing forgiveness and letting it go, that's something that Jesus would do. And that's who I want to be like. So I hope people will think I'm trying to follow Jesus and be a little more like him. And that's never a bad thing. Thanks for listening to me, friends. I'll see you later.
stars burning in the night. I see the mountains split the sky. I hear the song as it starts to rise. I shout your name, I shout your name. It makes me wanna clap my hands. It makes me wanna tell my ocean waves. As the sun fills the earth with praise, it shouts your name, it shouts your name. It makes me wanna clap my hands. It makes me wanna tell my friends I'm gonna lift my hands. I'm not afraid. Shout your name. Oh, I'm gonna lift my hands. Every day I'm lifting up my hands, hands, hands. For you I'm gonna dance, dance, dance. I'm lifting up my hands, hands, hands. To shout your name, Jesus. To shout your name, Jesus. Oh, oh. It makes me wanna clap my hands. It makes me wanna tell my friends.